And I'll say it again, I would rather have a friend with a cabin than one of my own, preferably several friends.
Okay, now just wait, Elizabeth. Not only is now a great time to maybe buy a cabin, but what if I told you that you could actually make money from it?
Then I want my own cabin.
Are you listening? Mm-hmm. Intrigued? Here with advice on buying that dream cabin, we welcome back our friends Julie and Daniel DeRoche from DeRoche Realty Group and Coldwell Banker Burnett. Hi, guys.
Hi, guys. Hi. Nice to have you here. You know, I love that you're starting with the location and the proximity to your house. We were just with our friends at their new cabin on Balsam Lake in Wisconsin. It's an hour and 10 minutes away. And my husband and I, every time we've been there, we drive back and we say, if we were going to get a cabin, that's where we would want it. Julie, that's something important to think about.
It is, and that's funny. That's where I've been looking for cabins with friends. So, a lot of people, you have to think, do you want to be close? Do you want to be able to go out there maybe after a sporting event or on the weeknight or go out for a night?
Yep.
Or do you want to have people out and maybe you don't want them to spend the night?
Yeah.
They can come out for the day and you can send them home. If you're close enough, you can do that.
See, because I like the idea of like this.
So that's one
going to Lake Minnetonka and just, having a Thursday night there.
Yeah, and that's very appealing. Now, on the flip side, some people want kind of that feeling of getting away.
And they want to be like in the North Woods.
Yes, you want to feel like you're up in a cabin. Maybe you don't want to be able to get called back to work or you really want to
feel more like a getaway.
Yeah, feel like a retreat for the weekend. Then you need to go farther out.
So this is an example of a property in Lutzen.
Yeah.
Okay.
We just listed that one. It is beautiful. But it's a 5-hour drive. But you're out there then. But then you're truly on vacation.
But then I feel like you got to do a full vacation there, whereas you can't do a Friday night. We go up there because then if you don't get there and it's, 10 or 11 at night, maybe if it's that big, you're happy when you get there anyway.
Yeah. Some people really love it. I mean, you hear about people who have cabins in Ely. I mean, it is that true, full getaway that they really love, and you love the road trip. Let's talk about the maintenance of it, though. So these are the hard questions where it's all, romantic to think, we're going to be there. We're going to have s'mores. We're going to have bonfires. There's going to be family memories. There's a lot of maintenance that comes along with owning a cabin. What do you want to think about?
Absolutely. You can have your cake and eat it too, so to speak. You could have a company out there that'll maintain the lawn, pick the weeds, do everything like that. If you don't, you really do have to plan. If you're heading out there Friday after work in a 5-hour drive, you get there at, 11 o'clock, 12 o'clock, depending on traffic. You got to get up the next day and spend 2-3 hours of your Saturday or Sunday mowing the lawn. It really bites into your entertainment. Or in the winter, if you're not there, who's going to maintain the snow? So you really have to think about those things. And a lot of people don't. Then they get the reality of doing it, and it might take some of the fun out.
Boy, and then if you're out in the cut, too, chances are you're dealing with a septic system. And those, if you have not dealt with one, can be a bit challenging. So that's an important question to be sure to ask your realtor if you're looking for a lake home.
Absolutely, yeah.
Yeah, especially if you're not used to it. If you have city water and city sewer, you have to plan on the fact that, hey, maybe in 5 years we have to replace the septic system.
Yeah, you might.
Well, in some cabins, they don't have a septic, drain field. It's just a big tank that has to be pumped, a couple times a year, depending on your usage.
Isn't that fascinating? Just goes right into that big tank.
And just waits there, waits to be pumped.
Holy moly.
I don't want that job.
Let's talk about this idea of, renting it out or joint ownership, where you're kind of thinking of this maybe more as an investment and you can share some of the cost and some of the workload. So consider renting out your cabin, Julie, on some of these different vacation sites.
We have a lot of people that do it. I think people do get worried about purchasing a cabin and maybe they don't have the funds to purchase exactly what they want. Mm-hmm. Or they worry we're only going to go up, once a month, but we don't want it sitting there empty. If you can rent it out by the week, by the weekend on sites like VRBO and Airbnb, and it works out great.
Who do you have to check with? Because that sounds great to everybody, but I'm sure there are some
situations. Yeah, some municipalities, cities have restrictions on those websites or short-term rentals, so you do have to check with that before. I would check before you purchase.
We've
just
done that,
know
though.
That it can always change.
Yeah, boy, we've done that up on the Whitefish chain. We've done it up near Garrison. It's just really a great way to kind of get a feel for if you like that area, too, even before you buy. Sharing with another family.
Yeah.
This sounds a little
scary. That sounds like
it
could get messy.
Yeah, you got to make sure it's really good friends or someone you actually don't know at all, I think, that in between would be challenging.
Okay.
And then what do you encourage them to do? Set up an agreement where it's fully stated, here's what this split will look like.
Yeah, you can actually get an LLC put together so both people are, 50% owners or however you want to do it. You could do 75-25. You really want to share the costs and the rewards, especially if you're renting it out. But, we actually talked about it personally with some close friends, and you want to make sure that you've got a really good understanding, because as we all know, I'm super high maintenance, so I would want it perfect, and maybe everybody else is very casual and the lawn isn't mowed right.
Let me tell you
so.
Something right now, Daniel. Daniel. There are a lot of things I'd like to split with you. Dinner, pitcher of beer, not a property. I just don't think I'd be able to live up to his.
I'm pretty particular.
There are a few things also you might want to think about how your life is going to be in the future, Julie. So this isn't just right now. What do you want to consider when you're making a purchase like this?
Yeah, we've had some people that maybe bought the cabin when their kids were little and weren't as heavily involved in sports. Mm. And now they're older and they have tournaments every weekend and they're running back and forth, or they're not being able to use the cabin as much because of those things. So just kind of thinking, how is it going to fit into our life long term? And maybe if it's not going to be long term, do you have an exit strategy? Are you willing to maybe rent it out if the market is down at the time you may want
to
sell it?
Look at that. All right. Thanks so much, you guys.
Boy, thank you guys.
It never fails, though. Every time we go to a cabin, we're like,
we got to get a cabin.
We got to get us one of these.
Or just more buddies with cabins.
Oh, taking friend applications.
If you are considering buying, selling, or building a home or a cabin, Julie and Daniel would love to help you out. Head to TwinCitiesLive.com for a link to the DeRoche Realty Group with Coldwell Banker Burnett.
And a big thanks to DeRoche Realty Group for sponsoring Twin Cities Live.